First and foremost, the majority of individuals would agree with the notion that notifying close friends about their wrongdoing or bad decisions will engender a myriad of advantages. The main reason behind this rationale is that friends are people who sincerely care about one another's well-being, a truth that led to the creation of a timeless maxim, a friend in need is a friend indeed. In other words, true friends must be willing to take risks, even if doing so has the possibility of ruining their friendship, out of the notion that they don't want their friends to be worse off. To illustrate more thoroughly, my older brother Keith recently went through a catastrophic experience with one of his best friends. Brian, Keith's close friend, had met the girl of his dreams, or so he previously thought before everything happened. Keith knew firsthand that Brian was quite ignorant and gullible when it came to his fiancée because Brian was head over heels for her. As their relationship became more serious, my older brother started to notice something strange about Brian's fiancée. Keith and a few of his buddies were contacted by Brian's fiancée on several occasions. Brian's fiancée called them on nights when Brian was out of town, usually on a business trip and nowhere to be found. As my brother, dad, and I talked about this, we realized that Brian's fiancée was actually hitting on my older brother and her soon-to-be husband's mutual friends. At first, Keith and his friends decided to keep all of this on the down low in order to avoid stirring things up for evidence that isn't concrete. However, one Saturday night, Keith spotted Brian's fiancée in a bar with a strange man acting suspiciously flirty. At that precise moment, my brother asked both me and my father what he should do, and we both said he should immediately tell Brian what he witnessed. Keith soon found out that Brian was away for the weekend attending a conference in a town nearby and told his best friend what was transpiring. Brian first denied any of the accusations about his fiance and got into a huge verbal altercation with Keith and abruptly hung up the phone. They didn't speak to one another for about 3 months, but in the end, Brian caught his fiance having an affair with another man, which was only possible since he started observing her actions more carefully. When all was said and done, Brian thanked Keith for the heads up and they mended their friendship. All in all, we can't and shouldn't overlook the fact that true friends should be more concerned with each other's well-being than playing it safe. Alright, so this example about my older brother Keith, who is a person that doesn't exist since I'm an only child, would be considered a non-personal example. So since we already wrote this example in the first body paragraph, please do not write a personal or another non-personal example in the following body paragraph, because even if the person that you wrote about is someone that is completely fictional, since you supposedly still know that person, it's still going to be considered more subjective than it is objective, okay? So if you wrote that kind of example in the first body paragraph, try to make it so that your second body paragraph's example is not so subjective, is more based on facts and more objective, okay? So a more objective example, a simple way to do this would be, imagine a personal example in which the main character is I or me, and change the main character to people, all right? So all you have to basically do is change whatever sentence that's in the first person point of view into a third person point of view sentence, okay? So I becomes people, I becomes students, or I becomes workers, whoever else you want to focus on, okay? All right, let's move on to the second body paragraph. On top of this, allowing friends to make horrible decisions will definitely result in countless unfavorable ramifications for both parties, your friend and yourself. In the eyes of many people in present-day society, what goes around comes around, meaning one's actions or inactions always have consequences. Needless to say, owing to the fact that people expect their friends to watch each other's backs, letting friends make a bad decision will inevitably destroy friendships. A great example of this would be people who were involved in drunk driving accidents. On most nights, friends go out and drink alcoholic beverages to release some steam, briefly forget about their duties, or escape from the mundane daily routines of their lives. Although all responsible grown-ups on the face of the earth know deep down in their hearts that driving under the influence is not only illegal but also outrageously dangerous, some choose to allow their friends to drive home after too many cocktails. The truth is, many friends do not want to seem overbearing or too mature, preventing them from acting like true adults in some scenarios. Subsequently, due to the lack of logical pieces of advice or precaution, many have become victims of car accidents caused by drinking. In the year 2010, a 19-year-old teenager and his 18-year-old friend were drunk and drove into a light pole in San Jose, California. Both of these teenagers were immediately declared dead as the car exploded in flames. If one of those youngsters were smart enough to act maturely and tell each other that they shouldn't get behind the steering wheel, both of them would still be alive and remember the night to be an exciting memory. Long story short, it's clear as day to me that prohibiting friends from making a poor decision is the right choice, even if doing so is at the expense of friendship. All right, so this second body paragraphs example was written in the third person point of view because I decided to focus on teenagers, okay? Teenagers instead of my friend or myself or another person that I know. Now, you could have also written about, I guess, Paul Walker, rest in peace, because he also passed away due to a car accident in which he crashed his Porsche into a tree. But I'm not sure if he was under the influence. So that's why I decided to just write about a news article that I remembered reading in 2010 about, yeah, you already read the example. Anyways, this is a good example of an example that is general, written in the third person point of view, but it could have easily been written about a person that you know. But then again, I avoided making the main character of a story like this a person that I know or my family member, because I would never want something this terrible to transpire to someone in my vicinity that I care for. All right? Alrighty, so those are my body paragraphs for this interesting and very thought-provoking essay topic. So on the outset, this essay topic is about friends, so it's very approachable, but when you get down to it, when you actually start trying to brainstorm the first and second body paragraphs, most people will probably find it difficult to separate the two body paragraphs without writing overlapping information. So what I decided to do was, in the first body paragraph, my focus was on how calling out your friend would be good. And in the second body paragraph, I decided to emphasize the possibility of things going dramatically wrong if you don't take this necessary action. Alrighty, if you guys enjoyed what you read and heard, leave a like on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you still have not done so. Share the content with your close friends and family members if they need the extra help. But most importantly, if you are a self-disciplined and dedicated person, reach out to me about my tutoring services. Let's get the score that you need and deserve in 2020. Peace out.